And Senator Elizabeth Warren was on iHeartRadio's The Breakfast Club show this morning, a program that has hosted several other 2020 candidates. At one point, one of the co-hosts asked the Democratic presidential candidate about her past claims of Native American ancestry. Here's part of the exchange.
When did you find out you weren't?
Well, you know, I'm not a person of color. I'm not a citizen of a tribe.
Were there any benefits to that?
No. Boston Globe did a full investigation.
You kind of like the original Rachel Dolezal a little bit. Rachel Dolezal was a white woman pretending to be black.
No, this is what I learned from my family.
Okay, we're back around the table. Nia, we were talking about this during the break.
Yeah, I mean, I thought the Rachel Dolezal comparison was a really low blow. I mean, if you remember, this is a woman who painted her skin, you know, darkened her skin and got a perm and passed for black. She was completely white. And Elizabeth Warren, you know, I sort of put it in the context of Elizabeth Warren. She's from Oklahoma. It's a southern state. You grew up in southern states. A lot of people claim Native American history, ancestry. Bill Clinton did. Johnny Depp did as well. Billy Ray Cyrus. So that's what the family lore is. I think this does remind us of an issue that had been dogging Elizabeth Warren. The president obviously has given her that nickname. But this is the answer she's landed on. This was what she learned growing up. She grew up in Oklahoma, which...
And she tried to get ahead of this.
Yeah, she did, with the DNA test, right, which, of course, really made Native Americans mad because that's not the way you determine Native American ancestry. And I've talked to Native Americans about this as well. They're also annoyed with the fact that she keeps saying she's not a person of color because that also has nothing to do with Native American ancestry or Native American tribal affiliation. It's all about whether or not you're part of a tribe or a nation.
Yeah, this is just, I mean, this is the answer she's landed on. The question is whether it's good enough. Mm-hmm. You know, in the sort of internal struggle, conflict with the Democratic base about who they think can win, mm-hmm, and who they're excited about, I mean, I don't think anyone sort of represents that better than Warren. And why aren't people more excited about Warren? The answer seems to be this issue. So until she can find an answer that satisfies the base on this, I mean, whether it's good or not, I mean, she was asked a couple direct questions in this interview and frankly didn't answer them. And now, you know, now it has the risk of becoming, you know, the Iraq question for Jeb Bush or the email question for Hillary Clinton. Mm. And, you know, I think it's good for her to keep getting these questions and try to find an answer that will